hope you're all having a great day so far. This video is a comparison between two ultra full coverage foundations, one I've tried and one I haven't tried. The first one is the Dermacol Film Studio makeup cover. This is in the shade 207, I think. I'm sure you've seen lots of videos on this already. It's marketed as the world's most full coverage foundation. This one is actually more for theater, I think. It's more of like a costume makeup. A lot of people have said that it doesn't last very long and it gets quite oily and it's thick. And the other one, which I have used many times before on my channel, is the Marc Jacobs Remarkable Foundation. Now, I don't think this claims to be the most full coverage this or the most full coverage that. It is just a really full coverage foundation to the point where I love full coverage and it can be too much sometimes. I'm thinking this one might be better in terms of longevity, like oil control, that kind of thing. Morphe G7 brush, my favorite for foundation. Give me all the coverage. So by the way, this foundation is meant to be 50% pigment and that's why it is so pigmented and full coverage. This is so like, videos that I've watched, most people have said that it's much too light. To be perfectly honest, I thought it would have been more full coverage. It's actually, it is full coverage of course, but I was thinking like, full coverage. It is beautiful. It's not as thick as I was expecting it to be. Like, maybe I don't apply enough. I need to layer it on. I don't know how people apply their brows before foundation. It's just, I feel like I'm working on a minefield. This is a gorgeous foundation. Same thing happened with that Zamora foundation that I tried, like the world's most, that was also the world's most full coverage foundation. And it was this beautiful, natural, like flattering foundation. It wasn't full coverage. This is actually full coverage, but that one wasn't. How pretty is that? I'm gonna have a smaller brush. I'm going to grab the Morphe Y16. Brush this one here and grab some more on my brush and work that around this area here. A lot of people have begun wearing this foundation as an actual foundation, like a day-to-day, and that would scare me because I thought this was stage makeup, and in which case stage makeup isn't usually worn 12 hours a day, every single day. It's just, you know, whenever you're on stage. But yeah, in which case I was wondering if it would then cause your skin to break out. But damn, this is really pretty, really pretty. But what I like about this is that you still have that glossy finish. So it still kind of looks like skin a little tiny bit. Whereas the Marc Jacobs one, I get a lot of comments. Whenever I wear that foundation, people are like, oh, maybe not the Marc Jacobs foundation in your skin, maybe not. Yeah, it can be pretty unflattering, especially if you have lines like I do. It settles right in and makes itself at home, and it doesn't have like a natural finish, so it can look very masky. Before, after, The difference in consistency with this is that this one is like a paste, and this is very watery. Like, look at that, that is how I was expecting this one to look. This is actually so beautiful. I can't get over that. Like, look at this. That is way more full coverage. That is exactly what Nikki's looked like in her video. But obviously a different foundation. What? I'm so confused. Definitely need to work fast with this one. Dries really quickly. And I guess it's what happens when it's not like emollient, it's so just liquidy, if that makes sense. Whereas this one takes much longer to, the way that has dried down is beautiful. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. Like, look at that. You can literally paint it on. It is paint. It is paint for the face. They're both definitely too light. This side, the Dermacol side, my eyes don't look all red and kind of weird. But on this side, and this always happens with this foundation, my waterline always looks really, really pink and red, like I've got some kind of infection in my eye, like pink eye or something. Whereas this one doesn't look as bad, which is weird and I don't understand why that is. Maybe this one has darkened a little bit as it's dried. Actually, I don't think it has that much. This one is just too light for me. I think that's what it comes down to. I'm just gonna wipe my corpse lips. Just realized I didn't even mention the shade. I was using the Marc Jacobs Remarkable Foundation in 10 Ivory Light. Oh, and I forgot to mention, in terms of pricing, the Dermacol one cost me $19.99 online. I don't know if that's AUD or USD, but it was $20. And to buy the Marc Jacobs Remarkable Foundation in Sephora, Australian Sephora, it would cost $79. What? What? Okay, so we're talking $80 versus $20. So literally a quarter of the price. I just checked to see if Dermacol and Marc Jacobs are cruelty-free. Marc Jacobs is cruelty-free, apparently. Dermacol is also apparently cruelty-free, but the sources aren't as legitimate as the ones that are telling me that Marc Jacobs is. So they've both had enough time to dry down and to oxidize and crease. As you can see, I'm looking down, both of them have creased, but the Marc Jacobs one has creased a lot more and in a shorter amount of time. This one is actually looking pretty good. So yes, in terms of creasing on the eyes, the Dermacol wins. Creasing around the mouth, to be fair, I have less mouth wrinkles on this side than I do this side, but the Marc Jacobs is definitely still more prominent. I don't know if you can see. Yep, definitely not as bad. Forehead is about the same. Might need to be ultra up close, which is very uncomfortable. But my pores on this side are really exaggerated by the Marc Jacobs one. It's almost just like the foundation has collected in my pores. Whereas on this side, you can still see my pores, but they're not nearly as emphasized as the Marc Jacobs ones are. I don't know if you can see that clearly. Yeah, you can see it. Even underneath my eyes, the Marc Jacobs one, this side, sorry, has creased quite a fair bit. Whoa, can you see that? Oh, I just took off my makeup in that one little spot. That's so annoying. Whereas on this side with the Dermacol, it looks amazing. Can't even really see, which is huge for me because I hate my stupid under eye creases, but it is what it is, so I just let them do their thing. In terms of finish, I still think, I mean, there's not a huge difference between the two. I still think that the Dermacol looks much more natural and I'd be much more confident wearing that out during the day. This one is fine. It still has somewhat of a sheen to it. It's just not as, I don't know, it just feels different. It's not the same kind of sheen. This is something that I would 100% wear again, and I'm kind of bummed at it is stage makeup because I feel a bit uneasy about wearing it every single day, but that is the kind of thing that I'm looking for, especially the fact that it doesn't crease or hasn't creased yet. That's a huge plus for me. So I'm going to go out, take Mimi, I'm going to come back, and I'm not going to powder, I'm not going to put concealer on, I'm just going to let them sit on their own, and I want to see how they last. So that is how it is looking. How beautiful is this Dermacol side? I have to cover my eyes because it's so bright. Look at that glow, like it's beautiful. And this is the Marc Jacobs side. I can't even look, it's so bright. My eyes are so sensitive, but yeah, that looks pretty nice as well. Not as nice as this side, I don't think, but they both held up really well, especially this side. The Dermacol is a lot better than I thought it would be. I thought it would be a lot more oily by now, like after being in the sun for a little while. Just changed the lighting conditions and you can see that, oh, look at that creasing underneath my eyes. That is not cute. This eye is way better so far. Marc Jacobs just creases so much. This side is looking much better, much more flattering than that side. Whoa. That side even makes my under eye like darkness look better. This side just makes it look worse. Whoa. Look at the creasing on my eye, even at the corner of my eye. It just looks horrible and it looks like I don't know how to set my face. Whereas this side is a million times better. I'll keep it on for a little bit longer, but definitely the Marc Jacobs one is a fail. And the Derma Blend, is it Derma Blend? God, I forgot the actual name of it. That one is really impressive. I definitely think the Marc Jacobs is more coverage for sure. Would I wear this again? Definitely.
but I'm scared about what it will do to my skin.
So it's a little bit later again, and I've decided that I'm not going to wear this foundation, either of the foundations, for the whole evening as well, because I can already tell. I already know my final thoughts. Nothing's changed since the past few updates. This side is amazing. This is the Dermablend. 100% better than the Marc Jacobs side. This part here of the Marc Jacobs foundation is fine. It did settle into my pores a lot here, and it's creased really badly. But in terms of longevity, it's pretty good. It hasn't come off in patches or anything like that. You can see where I've blown my nose. It's come straight off. And not so much on that side. So obviously it's just different formulas. The Dermablend one is obviously a whole lot more emollient and just doesn't sink into pores. It's just kind of sticks together rather than settling into the pores. And perhaps because the Marc Jacobs one is so watery, it just separates and clings to wherever it can. I don't know. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I hope you don't mind that I didn't film the whole entire night. I just didn't think it was necessary. I'm dying to have a shower and I just want to get this foundation off. But yes, Dermablend, thumbs up. Marc Jacobs, Remarkable, thumbs down. Thanks so much for watching, everyone. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye, everyone.